Okay. So, this is, it's got a back pedal brake. Coaster brake, that's what they're called. Now there's the lever that helps activate it when you pedal backwards. Amazed it still has this piece, this strap here. I usually just replace, you know, I don't, usually not on something I'm working on. So, and I just replace it with a piece of wire or plumbing strap or even, even zip tie, just whatever. It, even friction from these things usually gets the job done. But since we've got it, we're going to try and keep it. Always try to put things back together. You know, if they can live there in place happily. Shoot. There I do believe these have been rebuilt once, because these things are not centered in any way. Why we've got so many washers. Okay. This is my first coaster brake, so we're all along for this adventure. Together. I have a fairly decent idea what's happening in here. So there's, you know, two sort of conical things that when you back pedal and it catches this lever here, they work on a thread, and those engage with the outer, with the hub. So that's my understanding of this contraption and how it works. Man, there's a lot of friction in there. Okay. This is gonna be the wife's seat. She likes the horn. Okay. actually. I think this one will do better. I love this wrench. It's a wrench, it's a clamp, it's a whatever I need it to be. And can make it do. It's great. Absolutely great. Yeah. Made in USA. So we've got Germany, Sweden, USA. Still Germany, Sweden, USA. What are these things? Does it say? It doesn't say there. Alright. I got it. Of course, the recording is doing it. It all just gets shoved one place or the other. Oh, that was tighter. Okay. Good to know. This is one of those tools that was my dad's bike collection tools. A lot of that stuff in that box, well, I've added quite a bit to it. Is from that. He, back in, late 70s, early 80s, he rode, well, he made the distance, not the path, but he rode across the country. He rode from here to Southern California. Well, that's just old, that's rough one. Southern California, and then up to, I want to say Oregon. Where did that go? Oregon and back across, and then got sick in one of the Dakotas. Okay, well, if I can get it off, great. If I can't, whatever. I like to clean it. I cleaned all the rest of the sprockets. Is there a thread on it? No. Whatever. Clean it as best I can with UV blaster and rags. So far, everything but the pedals has had brackets for the bearings, so I'm hoping for that. Yep, that's what I see. Good deal. Yeesh. Super dry gross grease. Let's put this up things. Yeah, it was penetrating oil before I started. Well, I'll just
side is loose now. Yeah, you can see those cones there. Oh yeah, I hope there's no springs involved. I'm good. Glad to see it's greasy. That means getting greasy isn't going to be a problem. Well, let's back that off just a bit. Yeah, you can see that's all attached to the shaft. And the bearing for the hub is way out here. I'm separate. Okay, now we're doing stuff on the other side again. Put that so hopefully it all slides back together. Turn it around again. Looks like it went back together. Really stiff grease. Wow. Chunky and gross. Ew. Okay. Hoping it all comes apart. I don't see any springs. This makes me happy. Okay. Figure that out in a minute. Okay, yeah, so you can see that, yeah, this is a cone, and then when you backpedal, well, it all works out so that these little pieces push out against the internal hub. I'm gonna hold this up to the camera so I have a good idea of how it goes back together. Those are just in there. apart can I make this? Good question. Don't want to booger up any surfaces. I really should have brought my basket. Ouch. Fortunately, I think my toes slowed it down. Words out, obviously. Jeez. Ew. Oh. I'm sure that comes apart somehow, but I'm not sure what it is. They put that together on this piece. Boogered threads are a thing. Okay. Ooh, this is pretty bad. Already runs better than it did.
bronze. Done before the kids get home, or at least in the soak tank. I wonder if it's moving like molasses. Ha ha ha. Sheesh. Yeah, we're gonna need lots of soak time on this thing. Ooh, I hadn't thought of that. There's an inside to this shirt. I'm near as bad now. Same. Oh, I still got to figure out how to get that sprocket off. Nope, look at that, there it come. Figured it would. Change the diesel in the tank. Dry crud. Ew. Put a hair rag on before it was even worse. Yes, not. Nope, nothing is coming off of that without some soap. All right. Hey. Oh, yeah, there's that thread I was talking about. I just had to figure out how to work it right. I worked it right. This side's much less dry. Okay, that's a very thick walled. Oh yeah, I better hurry up if I'm gonna get the this there's a nut in the threads. That thread that's on that sprocket is on this too. Uh-oh, I hear him. I think that's him. No. There's a tractor. Coming on the big yellow thing. Who knows? It might even be magic. Ugh. Get this stuff in the soap tank. We all have a snack. Please. And scrape the junk off the outside here. Yes, yes, I do. The more you get off now, the less you have to deal with in the soak. Okay. I'm gonna go let all this soak in diesel fuel. Probably clean that up off camera too. I'm gonna give it a little spritz of this stuff real fast. A heavy spritz. Let's be real. It's bad. Got all the parts cleaned up. Oh, except this one. It's spectacular. Okay, so that's probably, that thing runs onto that. Yep, it's conical shaped. There's a cone in here that runs onto this part. You know, it helps keeps it keyed together so that the spline all works out right. Oh my goodness. Yeah, I said I was going to do this off camera, didn't I? But then I didn't. Yep. Cleany, cleany. But the inside's in first. Yeah. Just thinking out loud. Okay. Nice. because that's kind of it. That rag just got to go away. All right, so set this down. We're gonna move an awful lot of grease. Some parts up so that we can just shoot grease right onto them. These two, I don't think we need grease. No point in greasing stuff that doesn't need it. I did a dry assembly, make sure I was getting it all in the right order. I hope. Those little pieces together. Change them inside. I am not skimping on the grease. Anything I need to do? Super smooth. Okay. So, first thing we're doing is collets. Drop these in there. Like so. I'm thinking these need to go in. Okay. Good. We'll make it work. Oh yeah, these go in. either side of that. Trying to press it into the ball bearing because I couldn't get that out. Have the wheel.
What?
This is the wheel. Hey, please go put clothes on. If you're going to be outside, you need clothes. Please.
Ooga booga. What? Ow.
No dullness around here. Okay. Yes, it will come out. Move that there. And another schmuck. Okay. All right, then all that gets looped up real good. Side out, so that side out. this bearing. Might have got a little too much grease in that part. Not worried about it. Rather have too much grease than not enough. See how it turns. Yeah. Ever the tiniest bit of play in this. Of course, there's more. But when I put this possible. Get this one to work.
Moving on. Okay, whatever. It is what it is. Well, this is why other things are attached to it, right? Okay. Get as much grease off there because I waxed the chain that I'm putting on here. Because gravel is a thing. And don't be on lay back there. Yeah, I know what you're up to, Brownie. Domino. Stop it. Okay. Back here again. I'll do the final adjustment on the chain after a bit. Okay, so I think I know what all the extra washers were about. Yeah.
There we go. It's only in for aesthetic purposes, for the dome screw head. Okay, this is good. Junk off. Mm-hmm. There we go. That's the extra washer to get around that nut there, or the bolt holding on the finger. I need one over here too. Quick scrounge.
And ran the parts then. What luck?
Regional. New one. All right. Oop. Good deal. I'll go get another one. Now that I fully understand what they're for. All right, then. We're just going to finger these on because no point in doing anything more until I put the chain on. And that is probably going to happen tomorrow because it's time to go in and make dinner. Okay. Look at that. They both go good again. That is so much better than before. Everything goes out. That one just ain't got enough inertia to keep going. Cool. Bye.